everybody, and welcome back to The Poor Man's Chemist. In this video, we are going to be doing the prep of 5-bromovanillin from vanillin and bromine in methanol. This is the first step in the conversion of vanillin into 3,4,5-trimethoxybenzaldehyde, which, as we all know, is two steps away from mescaline. So this is a prep that I figure people will be interested in. It's real simple, guys. I don't really expect a lot of complications from this, which is good, because for the last few weeks, all I have fucking dealt with is complications. As many of you are aware, I have been trying to make ceric ammonium nitrate. I also started a new job about a month ago. So, between the ceric ammonium nitrate continually failing and me having to, devote a lot of attention to the new job so that I actually succeed in it, I just haven't had anything that I could turn into a video. This is, kind of pissed me off after a while, man. It's not like this period of time has been unproductive. I did finally figure out how to get past that damnable cerium dioxide and make cerium do something fucking useful for a goddamn change, which that was nice. I mean, 3 fucking weeks of work to figure out what the fuck I was doing wrong and to make it work, but we've gotten there. The reason I can't get the ceric ammonium nitrate to work is because my ammonium nitrate, as it turns out, is contaminated with a little bit of ammonium chloride. And I believe what is happening is that the chloride ion is reacting with the ceric nitrate and it is reducing it, because I can smell chlorine coming off the fucking thing. Usually a pretty good indicator. That was incredibly frustrating. However, like I said, I was able to get some shit accomplished. You can see here, I ordered 10 grams of cerium, and I was able to turn that into nice, beautiful, pretty ceric hydroxide. It's reasonably pure, and I might actually use this to make ceric acetylacetonate, because it's red, and it would, it'd be doing something with cerium, finally. Making the purish ceric, this is reasonably pure. I'm not making it using it reagent grade chems, although the cerium was very high purity. So, but this stuff should be pretty damn good. I made this by boiling a suspension of ceric perhydroxide that I made from cerous hydroxide that I had dissolved in HCl and hydrogen peroxide. I did get all of that on video. When I do the ceric acetylacetonate, I'll put the footage from that in that video so you guys can see how I actually made this stuff. But as you can see, it was a productive period of time. I did get something out of it, so I'm reasonably pleased by that, even if it was a complete fucking pain in the goddamn ass. Anyway, so to do our prep of 5-bromovanillin, what we're going to need to do is dissolve this in methanol and chill it down to 0C. I've already got the methanol cooling down in the freezer. It's been in there for a little while, so hopefully it'll be well on its way to being at the temp we need. Then we add the requisite amount of bromine to it without letting the temp get above 20C. Then we stir it for a while, and then we filter it and dry it and call it a day. Like I said, very easy and straightforward. If you've got bromine, this and vanillin, which should be pretty easy to get your hands on, this should be one that almost anybody can do. So with that out of the way, let's get into it. Okay, so the first step is to dissolve our 5 grams of vanillin and about 33 mils of methanol. This prep originally is written to start from 1 mole of vanillin, like 157 grams. I scaled that down just a little bit. All right, cool. I was hoping it would dissolve easily. Let me zoom in there. I didn't think it would dissolve quite that easily. Damn. Jesus. Okay. Well, I don't know what I'm complaining about, right? Normally it's a bitch and things don't dissolve. Okay, cool. Well, that was significantly easier than I thought. The methanol has been, well, I say that, but of course there's always got to be that little bit that won't fucking dissolve. Look at that shit. Man, quit being a pain in the ass, you whore. Dissolve. What the fuck? Like, all of it dissolves but a tiny little bit. What the hell? That's some bullshit. Whatever. Anyway. We have to cool this down to 0°C, so I've got some ice and some salt here. I'm going to make an ice bath with that and put a thermometer in this bad boy and get it chilled right down. From that point, we have to add 2.89 grams of bromine to this bitch. And we can't let the temp go over 20°C. I think I might have mentioned that earlier. I'm probably just going to go ahead and weigh out 2.89 grams of bromine into a vial. I think that's going to be the easiest way. If I try to weigh this bottle and take 2.89 grams out of it, it's going to be very crude. I know I'm going to lose a little bit as I try to do that because it just happens every fucking time. You'll lose a drop here or there. Bromine's very dense, so a little bit of it, you know, one drop will throw your weight off a good bit. So whenever you're working with bromine, you always want to make up a little aqueous sodium thiosulfate. Just put a little bit of this shit in some water and have it handy, because if you get bromine on your skin, this shit is like liquid fucking fire, man. I've gotten this shit on my skin many times. Sodium thiosulfate dissolved in water will immediately convert bromine into non-burning bromide. But I have learned this from experience. Bromine tends to stick to the skin. So in your container of aqueous sodium thiosulfate, if I were you, I'd put a washcloth in there, because you're going to need to scrub that spot to get it off of there. But I mean, you do that, get it quick. You probably won't even leave a mark if you're smart and fast. I don't know. I'm kind of used to getting little drops of bromine on me and it burning like crazy. I've resigned myself to it. I don't know. Don't be a pussy. All right. So I'm going to try doing this in this bowl. Yes, the heat definitely is not on. That would be bad. Hopefully with a dark background like this, everything will stand out and be nice and visible. I hope. I don't know. So anyway, I'm going to get this chilled down, get the thermometer in there, and I will come back when we are ready to add the bromine. Chem peeps, that was fun. So the next step in the protocol is to take this out of the ice and let it stir at room temp for an hour. I don't know, everything else about this procedure is done with chilled stuff, But whatever, we will follow the protocol and do what it says. I'm going to cover this up with a watch glass. Hopefully that will prevent a lot of methanol evaporation and keep tree jizz, the eternal bane of my existence, from falling in there. So I will come back when this is done stirring. All right, so our solution stirred at room temperature for an hour, and now I've got it back on ice. It is chilled down to 0 degrees C, and we have to add 16.5 mils of ice cold water to this over the course of 30 minutes. I have my ice water over here, and I'm probably just going to time lapse this again because it's going to take so long. So, here we go. This is our stuff. I added in the water over the course of about 30 minutes, and then we're supposed to let it keep stirring for about 15 minutes. I let it keep stirring for about 30 because I was working on getting some other stuff ready here. So now what we need to do is filter this stuff and get our final product. There, can you guys see this shit? I hope. Zoom in a little bit. Well, maybe not quite that much. Okay. Seriously, son of piece of shit? This is what you're doing today? Oh, you gotta be an asshole, camera. Alright. Maybe stir this up a little bit. There we go. Let's hope that it is easy to filter. Easy to filter, maybe? Yeah? Yay! Easy to filter. Smells like vanilla. Okay, seriously? Where the hell is it all? There we go. Okay. I was about to say. For a second there, I'm like, where the fuck is it? Alright. Now we need to rinse it with water. This water has been chilling in ice water for a while. The paper does not say that it has to be ice water, but we're going to go with that anyway, just to be on the safe side here. Come on, get on out of there now. I'd like to get a decent yield, you know, if at all possible. If I read this right, man, we're supposed to get like a 95% yield, which would be pretty tits. I don't know, I'm dubious, but alright. Very pretty. Very, very pretty. Now, we are supposed to rinse this with 16 mils of 70% methanol at 0 degrees C. I have that chilling in the freezer right now. I want to be very sure that is nice and cold, especially since it kind of looks like the yield sucks a little here. I don't know, I can't tell. It better not suck. Okay. That was the requisite amount of water. Let this suck dry here. Then we will go get our methanol wash. Alright, I'm going to try a little bit of this here. Just see what happens. Better not dissolve my shit now. Okay, looks good. Yay! It's pretty. All right. Now we're going to let this suction dry. And we will take a look at this here in a minute, and we will wrap this up. All right, everybody. There we go. I'm hoping this is showing up right here on the camera. In real life, this is a nice light yellow powder. Breaks apart very easily. Seems to be drying pretty easily. The paper says to dry it in vacuo at 50°C. I don't know that I'm going to go that far, man. I ain't selling this to anybody. I ain't writing any papers. Yeah, I'm happy with this. I'll dry it out in the desiccator like I usually do, and hopefully that will be sufficient and it won't cause it to horribly break down and turn to shit. Anyway, so yeah, as I predicted, a nice, straightforward, easy to do organic synthesis where basically nothing could go wrong. Yay, finally something fucking worked. God damn it. I'm so happy. So, if that was good for you too, give this a thumbs up, you know, comment on it. Tell me if you loved it, if you hated it. Hopefully I will have something better for you guys on the next one. I don't know. I mean, I know this was a kind of phoning it in a little bit. This was very, very simple prep, but like I said, man, I just needed something that fucking worked. Besides, I was going to get to this one eventually. So, you know, it's not like it wasn't on the list. So, anyway, until the next one, you guys, I will see you later.